Previously on Let's Play Populous the Beginning. For the first time, we had to take on two tribes, the Chumara and the Matak. My objective was to get both tribes to turn against one another, but I decided, screw that, I'm going to take them both down. But what kind of things will we unlock in this part? Let's find out. If I can do a lot of damage to this base, that'll be a victory, but the bad news is their shaman just respawned. And unfortunately, I know the first thing she will do is try to cast a spell on my men. Or maybe she'll just walk over there and not give a That works too.
Taka.
And welcome back to Let's Play Populous the Beginning. Last time we took on two tribes in level 6, and now we're moving on to the unseen enemy. That sounds pretty serious. So let's see what this level has to say for itself. The Chumara will use the spell of invisibility to attack us once again. I sense a stone head that contains a prize, the spell of Erode. Then I will seize the power of invisibility from their vault of knowledge. Alright. So there's what we are trying to reach. And I'm going to guess that's the invisibility spell. So here we go. Guys, unfortunately, my first attempt failed. The problem I had in this level was I simply waited too long to attack. Their shaman casted the invisibility spell on some of their men, and they came into my base, started attacking, and I couldn't see them, and everything just went downhill. I simply didn't attack soon enough. I was way too focused on getting a bigger base. So, how did I change things up in my second attempt? Let's take a look. We join the gameplay where a group of warriors is worshipping the Stonehead to unlock the Erode spell. Where is their shaman? I'd like to know where she is so I can see. There she is. Look at that ugly thing. Alright. Couldn't care less if any of their other guys come over here, just not their shaman. So we can get that spell and mess up their tribe really, really good. Otherwise, we have our army ready, and as soon as we're done worshipping this thing, I'm probably going to go in for my first attack. So, fingers crossed, we can get this all worshipped out, and before this little butt face comes over here, kills them all. And there we are. Yes, we got a road spell. I'm so excited. And the shaman didn't do anything this time. Loser. So let's hurry up and get this last road spell so we can go in for our first attack. And my debate is, should I just say forget it and attack him from over here, or should I cast that land bridge, kill all these mofos right there, and that preacher up there? I see you up there, buddy. You can't hide from me. And kind of sneak around back here to their vault of knowledge. It's probably going to be best to sneak around back here to their vault of knowledge. Fingers crossed their shaman hasn't casted that Dane invisibility spell to where I'll run into some guys that I cannot see. The shaman's moving. Hang on. We gotta get ready here. Hurry up. There we go. Don't you dare try that again, buddy. The best part is, killing their shaman, I got some Romana, and that made my lightning spell charge pretty fast right there. So I hope they get this done quick, because it would be the perfect time to go attack them right now without their shaman trip-trotting around over there. And there we go. That is it. We are going to go in for our first attack. And I know I only have two Braves left. That's kind of scary. And yeah, I'm going to send all my guys over there, which is even scarier. But there are some wild men running around, so if they, for some reason, they do come and kill my base off, I at least might be able to rebuild it. But I really want to go in and do some damage before, especially before they start making invisible guys, if they haven't already. I don't know if her shaman has. My last attempt, though, a little message popped up warning me. I have a feeling in the future levels that will not happen. So this game's gonna get even more serious. Actually, you guys should probably stay back. I don't like those preachers right there. Wait for the shaman to get there so we can lightning them. Or I could just kill him. Actually, just to save up on the lightning spells, I think I'm going to... No, I can't. It's out of range. Darn it. Forget it. I'll lightning them. I'm just going to kill him. Can't make up my mind today, guys. We got fire. We can use those. I just want to do my best not to waste my spells here. This could go very, very wrong. We're going to go ahead and lighten those guys. There we go. That preacher is still up in that guard tower. I don't know if I want to use lightning on that. I definitely don't want to waste my... Oh, that twit punch. And we're going to convert some of their guys. Yes. How many other guys we got? Still got 10 warriors, so that's good news. Go ahead and let them kill those Braves off. I really don't want these preachers to take too long, though, because I really want to get in their base and really start to do damage before they come over here and get me. So I'm just going to let them kill that guy. I don't think it's worth wasting our time on that one guy. And we're going to kind of sneak around to the back over here. And let's see, where's that stupid shaman of theirs? Fingers crossed they don't have any invisible people. Because the scary part is the shaman's going to have to worship with their base right there. And obviously we're not going to be able to cast any spells, so we're going to have to do our very best to protect our shaman. If she gets... Hang on. What's going on over here? We got an invisible preacher. Oh, it's just that one guy. It's not worth our time. You know what I am going to do, though? This actually might be worth saving some time, wasting some time. I may go ahead and just cast an erode spell right there and just trap their shaman right there. Kill their shaman, trap her over there. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. So, hold up there, buddy. Go this way. Don't let those preachers run you off there. Yeah, I should. I don't know why I didn't think of this before. So, yeah, we are definitely going to separate their shaman. Now, of course, the mission will be to kill their shaman. Downside is the shaman's gonna be trapped there, and if she responds, I don't know how I'm gonna be able to kill her, so that's the scary part about this. So I'm because you have to remember their shaman does have to be dead for you to win the level. That's the annoying part, but we're gonna go ahead and make another attempt here to worship. Oh no, get away from the preacher, guys. Dadgummit. Guys are ruining my chances. Stay away from their base. Stay away from their base. Is their shaman moving or is she just chilling?
Ain't she?
Alright, guys, come on. Hurry. What's going on? What's up with all the screaming down here? Ugh! Oh, you guys, I didn't want you to go over here right now. You guys are really messing everything up. Hurry up, shaman, hurry up. Oh, I'm so close. I'm losing a bunch of my guys here, so this attack is pretty much an epic fail, but maybe I can at least kill their shaman and get her trapped. Okay, so we're gonna get the spell. If anything, we are gonna go ahead, let our preachers do their work, and we are going to kill their shaman. So, at least she is gone. she'll be trapped on her own little island over there for a while. Unless she casts the Lambridge spell, which I predict she will do, but hey, maybe that'll buy us some more time while we can do some damage to their base over here. And you know, just so we can see it, I am going to cast Invisibility. And I only got one guy in that, because they're squirming too much. There we go. And when your guy, they're moving around so fast, but your guys will look dimmed. Alright, where's the preaching going on? Oh, our shaman might die here, guys. Yeah, let's see if we can do a little bit more damage before... Oh, she is back. She's just standing over there on the sidelines. Gonna go ahead and charge some more spells here. Visibility spell's gonna take a little while. I suppose if I really wanted to save some time, I could cast my final erode spell. You have to be aware, though, if you cast cast the erode spell, some guys chilling over it, and they could sink into the water. So you kind of have to tread lightly, and that would be there goes the death of my shaman right there. And I predict she will cast a land bridge soon. But that is going to be That is going to be it for my first attack. I need to go make some more guys here. And definitely convert some more wild men. But trapping their shaman on their island for a while isn't a bad thing. And one of my warriors somehow made it out of there. I can't believe it. You are the lone survivor. And why are you braves not in a hut? Have you been sitting out here the whole freaking time? And looky here, we got more wild men, so we are gonna stop charging these spells. We gotta get guys here quick so we can go in for another attack, because I'm sure they are going to want their revenge, and this would be the perfect time for them to come jack me up, because I have no guys at all whatsoever. So we need to hurry up and charge this so we can get lightning charged again, get that charged, everything charged, and do some more damage as quick as possible. Come on, come on, come on. Until then, guys, we'll come back when we're ready for attack number two, or sooner if necessary. And guys, we're about to go in for a second attack because they are starting to rebuild everything and train more guys, so we need to get over there and do some more damage. So, we're going in with a smaller army this time because I don't want to waste any time. I don't want them to get any more powerful. I want to get this attack going pretty quick before they get too big again. And I've really had to become a lot more strategic with what spells to charge and which ones to leave off. I definitely want to leave lightning on because that's great for getting groups of people. But man, it charges slow. Charges painfully slow, even if you just have only two spells charging at once. And we're going to have our warriors stay back here. And we're going to see if we can get these preachers to convert their guys. We'll go ahead and send the shaman up with them in case a bloodbath starts. That way my army can just be a little bit bigger. And their shaman is still trapped over there, so that's good news. I should be able to kill her as soon as I kill all the other guys. So we'll see if we can get some more of their guys. Shaman standing by to beat them up. Or just having the warriors stay back so they don't... In fact, we're going to get him out of there so he doesn't start punching them on by mistake. That has happened before. Go ahead and send them over here. Come on, preachers, hurry up. You gotta go faster. Okay, good, good. We got more preachers. Hey, no. I want more guys. For shaman. Alright, fine. So he killed one of my warriors. Y'all just go over here and listen to the sermon. It's interesting this guy's just kind of standing there doing nothing. There we go. There we go. Awesome. So we just grew our army a little bit, courtesy of our preachers, and we are gonna go right back in. And I do have a swarm spell if things get too crazy, and two lightnings. But we're gonna see if we can do our best to save up those spells. Actually, I'd like to use it right here because they're all in a huge group, so that's gonna do some damage right there. Start ripping their buildings down, especially that and that. Hopefully we can keep the shaman alive at least. I think we're doing okay though, so far. We got a big group over here. Gonna do another lightning attack. Make some human fireworks, I guess. I don't know what to call it. And we actually converted some of their braves, it looks like. Good job, preachers. You guys must be very good at preaching sermons. I'm so proud. I think we're going to have this level beat, guys. I don't want to jinx myself, but with their shaman trapped in La La Land over there, I don't see how they can win. Oh, no, you don't. I hate wasting that last lightning spell on that preacher, but I cannot lose my warriors. I don't want any chance of them getting more powerful. In fact, guys, forget about the training huts. Let's go over here and get rid of their warriors. Where's the preacher? I hear one of their preachers babbling. I think they converted a bunch of my guys. There, that'll quiet him down for now. If I can get there... Where are my warriors? Are they all getting converted? Because I don't have any spells I can cast to stop it. But fortunately, we did some heavy damage and maybe time to retreat because I can't lose all my guys. I'm in deep doo-doo if I do. Unaga. This is a little tribe that will not go down without a fight. You know what? Fortunately, we are actually converting more of their guys still. Where's the... If I could kill all their preachers, that would be a victory, because then I could just use my preachers to convert all their guys, and then we can maybe still win this level without having to go back to my base to make more guys. Just there's so many... It's a tough thing about this game is there's so much going on at once, it's hard to... It's hard to pick a focus. You know what? I'm gonna kill some of my guys doing this maybe. Oh, come on. I was hoping it would, man, that was a waste. Really hoping it would sink enough to where it'd destroy their train hut. Forget the lightning, let's just charge up some fire so maybe I can cast some last minute spells here. In all honesty, I should probably go back, but I'm kinda relying on my preachers to convert more of their guys at the last minute. So their preacher really isn't doing anything over there. And their braves don't seem to be hurting my shaman too much. Things are getting pretty crazy, and I guess their shaman just keeps dying automatically because she was dead over there. So I was kind of worried about me not being able to get to her after I kill off their tribe, if I can. They don't want to give up. Be a plus if I convert all their braves, because then they can't do anything. We're gonna go ahead and take our shaman over here. There's not, doesn't look like they have that many guys left, so if we can convert that last guy or kill him, we might have this level beat. There could be some guys hiding in the hut, but I think that might be it. In fact, no, there's some other guys around or some. Okay, there's a guy right there. Yeah, there's some guys in their huts, but I think we have this level beat. Shaman, yeah, you don't have to tell me twice. Just to speed this up a bit. Since we have four of these, might as well use them, right? And he went back inside the hut, that bum. Oh no. No, sir. You know, I'm not gonna waste my time on this one guy. Want to kill all of them. That preacher's almost dead. Beat him up, shaman. Do your duty. I said duty. Alright. Where are the last of them? Or is that it? We just have to kill their shaman. Their shaman respawn? Yes, it looks like they did, and I do not have a land bridge. Let's see. Let's just make sure there's no guys left out here. We can go ahead and start charging this up, and we can go kill their shaman and call this level complete. Yes, I believe all the guys are dead, and we just have their shaman left, so we have no other spells charging, and we have one fire spell to kill their shaman. Boy, wouldn't that be just a tragedy if I was trying to go over there and kill their shaman? She just struck all of us with lightning and killed all my guys. That was the... Oh, they do have some guys left. Oh, no. Yeah, let's just go ahead and rip down all their huts so they can't build more crap. I saw a guy pop out right there. We're not gonna let this happen. There we go. So we'll kill that guy, and that should be it. And no, I'm not going to charge fire up at the same time. I just kind of want to... This is the only... I want this to be the only one charging, and we will come back when we are ready to kill their shaman. And guys, we about have our land bridge spell, and as you can see, the shaman's just standing right there waiting for us. I'm trying to tread lightly here because I wonder if she has lightning. In fact, I'm going to have my guys kind of fall back here a little bit because I don't want to lose all my guys to one freaking spell. So here we are. We're going to go ahead and cast the Lambert spell. We'll select all our guys here. Luckily, there she is. Go ahead and... Oh, that was a fine time to miss, Shaman. Come on, guys. Help her out. Help her out. Help her out. There we go. Booyah. That is the end of the level. Wouldn't say that went 100% smoothly, but it went better than my first attempt. So, I think that was pretty much the main strategy right there, is just trapping their shaman on that island using the erode spell. So, guys, that was it. We'll play some more Populous on Thursday. Thank you guys so much for watching. Like, subscribe, and... Of course, I'm always open to any suggestions on how I can make this channel better, so just keep watching, keep commenting, tell your friends, and I will see you next time.